Don't mention the moment.
Send a blue alert so people know.
I'm gonna document this. I'm gonna stay on the other side. I have to document this thing.
We have to be very insistent on our right to document. Of course, you see that they tried getting us out of the area, but those guys in the Aloha shirts are police. They're what we call Aloha police, public affairs officers. They split the whole area up, as you can see, to make it very difficult to cover. As you can see on the other end, while we're here, is a huge backhoe and a dump truck. That's why I have another camera with me, and what I try and do is zoom in at least a little bit to get the picture there. And we try to have more than one documenter, live stream or video, so that one can get one end. While people get this end, you can see that we got pushed out of this end where the free speech wall is, because I want to cover that destruction. And while that's going on, there is action going on the other end with that backhoe. That is Trish Morikawa. She's the coordinator of the Office of Housing. We call it the Office of Dehousing. Here we go. Here is the First Amendment wall that had signs that were tagged yesterday. These signs went up. This wall went up during the last off-art after dark, which was the end of last month. You can see they always bring their own cameras and stuff, so that's subpoenaable in any action. They have two cameras, two video cameras. There has been an installation here, and now let me point that way, because there is a backhoe there while this is being destroyed. There is... Okay, so there are two things going on here, this wall and that backhoe. And they make it... they cordon off the entire area, as you can see, in order to make it difficult to document. We've done a pretty good job at documentation. Of course, these signs are not going to be stored. They will be they are being destroyed on site. I want to make sure that we see that there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, about a dozen police here. This is the corner where the original deOccupy Honolulu encampment stood. In solidarity with Occupy Wall Street, is currently the longest running continuous encampment in the world. There has been a presence here, a residence here on the corner near, actually on the sidewalk side, for more than 1 year. More than 365 continuous, uninterrupted days. These tents, I'm going to move here. I'm right, you know, people say, why don't you get a little closer? Well, as you can see, this whole area is cordoned off and guarded by armed police while this is going on. There's the pile of stuff. As I was saying, these tents that they're looking at now are not subject to seizure because they've been rotated out to private property, from private property. So, you can see the backhoe there, which is a frequent familiar site. Now, on this end is the deoccupy on encampment. On the other end, you can see the blue-shirted crews. There is also a homeless encampment. We call it South Occupy. And if this political action over this past year has done anything, it's given a lot of political activists who have come through the deoccupy encampment and protest. Solidarity with homeless people, because we've witnessed and documented their stuff being stolen. These are clear violations of Fourth Amendment, and all property rights. You have a right to property, whether whatever your circumstances are. In particular, there's a necessity for the things required for the acts of living if you don't have much. If you don't have a private residence, you must live in public. And that doesn't mean that you don't have a right to private property, because you certainly do have a right to private property, even if you are living in public. Now, if you're watching this for the first time, it seems a little grotesque to see a backhoe trashing homeless people's stuff, but welcome to Honolulu, Hawaii. Welcome to Thomas Square. Welcome to homelessness in Honolulu. There, there isn't, this, the actions here are not unique to the area. When the crews come here, they've come from another camp. They go to another camp from here. Here are the new crews. These crews, if you've joined us, followed the last few times, are... I'm glad I'm getting... You know, the difference between yours and mine is that everybody can see mine and nobody can see yours. You know, you're using yours for your purpose and I'm using mine for the good of the public, so the public can see. Okay? You can see the splintered paddle on the emblem of every policeman, and that is the symbol. That's a symbol of the Kanawai Mamalahoi, the law of the splintered paddle proclaimed by Kamehameha I. That is Kenneth Shimizu, deputy director of the Department of Facilities Maintenance. Earlier we saw Trish Morikawa, who is the coordinator of the Office of Housing. We call it the Office of Dehousing. You'll see that there are and get a better angle here. Taking the signs and the problem I think with the First Amendment, the Fourth Amendment is the They're really hard to accommodate. So a lot of municipalities have said, let's pretend like they don't exist. And there's the refuse and resist sign. That refuse and resist sign has survived many raids, and apparently is not surviving this one at all. Now, luckily today we have a camera on the other end, a couple. As you can see, they block off the traffic here. This entire lane is cordoned off, and this entire area is cordoned off. One reason to do it, of course, is to prevent documentation. There are about a dozen police. I can, I have a second camera here, and I am zooming in. I can kind of tell you what's going on that end. You can't really see it very clearly. The backhoe is got a shovel load and just dumped it into the back of a dump truck. So there's no storage of property at all. You can see and hear the property being thrown into the that area. Now what I'm going to do, since everything is gone from this area, I'm going to go to the other side. Now instead of being able to just walk around to the other side, you can see I have to go through the park where I can't see anything. Now you can see here from this end there are parked trucks here. They come in through the other end, and This is raid number 51, probably. Here we go at this end. Sorry, I want to walk. You can see this area is completely cordoned off. In order to keep this kind of stuff from the public eye. And you can see these signs taken from the other side here. So I was saying this is raid number 51, I believe. I have my spreadsheet at home. But it has not stopped an occupation of this corner by more than 365 continuous days. This is the longest running Occupy encampment in the world. We've always had a presence on this corner for every single day since November 5th, 2011. We are at Thomas Square, historic place where sovereignty was returned to the Hawaiian people on July 31st, 1843. Across the street is the Honolulu Museum of Art, previously known as the Academy of Arts, and before that, the private residence of Anna Rice Cook. There are perhaps about, I counted 11 policemen in one frame. So there are about a dozen at least police here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 here. They divide people up to make it difficult to difficult to document. Now, while this is going on in the other corner, the occupy the what we call South Occupy, the homeless corner encampment, they're getting raided. So they're very underdocumented. Let's go check out how they're being treated over on that side. As you can see, I can't just walk over there. The line of sight is blocked. Here are the city crew. I'm gonna walk over on this side, see how they're doing. You can see that their possessions being taken. Now this is an actual homeless encampment, and what you see here, mattresses, well-organized food supplies, clothing, tents, and that sort of thing. That's being taken, that's being trashed, you know? And it's being trashed by the Office of Housing and the Honolulu Police Department. I have to say, I've said it before and I'll say it again, the homeless people are among the most well-organized people. And their stuff is being seized.
Here's the thing. Thank you. Thank you for actually doing something.
You didn't keep a handle on your employees. You knew damn well that that tent wasn't there yesterday, and yet you let them enter it. Why don't you have something to say about it, Trish? Why are you letting your employees break the law?
They get some kue from the people that occupy solidarity with the. This sort of thing has been ruled as unconstitutional by the Ninth Circuit Court in Los Angeles, which is, has the jurisdiction over Honolulu too. So it's waiting for. Legal challenge in Hawaii courts, and sooner or later, of course, they will be obliged. Now, here is interesting if you're just following us. This truck has, you see these bins in here. And those bins are, supposedly where, I'll explain it later.
Ninth Circuit Court ruling, you read it yet?
You let people utter their pet? What's your guys' excuse? Why are you holding people in line? Stop bumping into me, man. I'm not touching you. Give me 3 feet. Show the fucking respect. What fucking line?
Here, these bins in this truck are where items that are seized are stored. Supposedly for 30 days. But, from experience, I can tell you that in order to retrieve property that are in these bins, you must produce credit card receipts for everything, and then have to go up to a place in Halawa where buses don't run. Now, think of your own tent. If you're watching this, you probably got some internet service and that sort of thing. The tent you got that you go camping in or whatever, can you produce a credit card receipt for that, or for your suitcase, or your clothes into it?
If you're so fucking concerned about what's going on, why are you arresting them?
I'm concerned about you.
Why are you concerned about me and not concerned about the fourth, fifth, fifth,
your health is like
my health. Really? My health is your concern. Then why would you allow BFM employees to steal people's tents where they got a sleep? My health is your concern? This is a direct conflict with my health.
There's been a lot of problems with
they're taking the happy birthday banner.
The happy birthday
happy
banner.
Happy birthday for deOccupy.
Oh, that's...
Oh! Oh,
that's mean. You just joined us. We are at deOccupy Honolulu, Thomas
like
Square.
There was no sleep over there. They were like, fuck that shit.
Oh, we can't go past the big back camera. I don't want to answer
one of
for
the,
my
frustrations.
I'm
going
to go hide behind the tape. Like
I'm trying to get you some education. Why are you walking away from me? You talked about how much you want to help the houseless. I was just trying to help you.
Your friends, your fellow officers are going to be on the street as a result of BFF.
Ninth Circuit Court ruling, printed out, trying to hand it to Trish. She won't take it. Officer!
You guys do realize that, right?
That is the Ninth Circuit Court ruling. The opinion is the one that says this sort of thing is unconstitutional.
Yo, right over there, there's a bunch of criminals. Why don't you do something about it instead of film me?
Now, Trish Morikawa is actually a licensed attorney. And was a deputy prosecutor under the current mayor, the outgoing mayor. So she definitely knows police are helping steal this stuff. The usual bin truck has a crane on it. They have a smaller truck today. Their actual amount of stuff that goes into these bins is very small. As you can see, most of the stuff taken here goes directly into the trash. These are effectively go indirectly into the trash because very few of the little of this stuff is actually reclaimed. It requires credit card receipts and that sort of thing. Tents aren't allowed on the bus, even folded up, so even if you can get a bus to the nearest place, walk up the hill, reclaim your tent, you need a private car to do it. As a result, very little of this stuff that has been confiscated has been recovered. And remember, the things that have been confiscated have survived being trashed. Now the question is this a solution to homelessness? The people who this stuff was seized from are on the street. And they have less stuff than they had a moment ago. They don't have their tents. They don't have their clothes. And they don't have food. Food is instantly trashed because it's perishable. There are kind of a couple of issues here. Political protests, First Amendment, Fourth Amendment rights, and just human decency. And political solutions. Now, the amount of money spent on this sort of solution, of course, is no solution at all. There in the center, in the baby blue. You know, Trish is going to have to stop wearing my clothes to these raids. You know, if she doesn't stop wearing my clothes down here, I'm going to start wearing her clothes down here. You know what I'm saying?
Are you willing to actually help educate your fellow employees? Oh, congratulations, it's okay, fellas. Another good day out of the job.
All right. High five. We got to be criminals again today.
Trish.
Trish is wearing my clothes.
Congratulations. Well done. Good job. Good job, Trish. Trish. You make sure you read that. You're a lawyer. You have it. You have it. Have you read it yet?
Okay, the tape's down, people are going. Let's see if we can get a little close to the contents of that garbage truck. They're going to the Kapilani homeless camp. And you saw the dump truck behind me? Actually, there were two dump trucks, one garbage truck. Tent still here, yay! deOccupy still stand. And there goes the management team on a separate.
Identify. I need an officer to stop refusing to identify herself. What is your name and badge number? Do not refuse it. You know damn well where this is going to go. You cannot refuse to identify yourself. What is your name and badge number? I can do this all fucking day, ma'am. You're the one breaking the law. I'm not an officer of the law. You have been told to reveal your name and badge number. What is it? What is your name and badge number?
My name is Officer Chingʻs. My badge number is 2152.
Alright. Was that so fucking hard?
And it just goes to show you gotta keep asking sometimes. Good job, Andy. Andy Smith, iZombies on Ustream. If you wanna see the stereo view, there will be iZombies on Ustream. Good job, Andy. Just keep asking. I think you did good. It just shows, you know, sometimes people think we're being rude, but, you know, sometimes you got to keep asking to get the info. And people are leaving. Here's the backhoe and dump truck going to... I heard them say Kapi'olani, so if you're in the Kapi'olani area and there's a homeless camp, be warned. These guys are coming, pack your stuff up, and you know, I don't want to tell you to run away, but keep your stuff, man. We need more Ustreamers, videographers, Twitter people at... homeless camps, man. If somebody wants to get like a little project together and cost it out, you know, you can pass it by me. I think there are groups like the Hawaii People's Fund that might fund such a thing if you can figure out how to administer it. Not much stuff in here, so they're going to go to multiple camps and they're not expecting to pick up much stuff. Aloha police in there, all going off to the next place. And that's it, folks. You can see deOccupy encampment still stands, as it has stood for more than a year. Bunch of tough guys here. We did have, Kathy did give Trish a copy of the Ninth Circuit Court ruling, so she is in receipt of that. I'm sure she's read it. She is an attorney. I'll show you that these tents are tagged.
Okay. That one guy that you keep having a problem with, the one officer, you know, the guy that was, the one that was insulting Hawaiians and doing all that crazy stuff, I specifically asked him about what was going on and asked him, or told him that I wanted to file a complaint. He said, no problem. And I sat back down quietly and started a bunch of trouble. It's on camera, by several people's cameras, including his own.
Good.
So now that he walked away and denied me my civil right, on top of illegal search and seizure and the 4th and 14th Amendment, now he denied me, due diligence for filing a report. So we're going to go down to the HPD so I can file a report on it.
Okay. Okay, good. Sure that was on it's the on, it's on there. We got
on.
Really good bandwidth.
Yeah,
it clears the...
Yeah, I didn't
great.
Start a bunch of trouble. Didn't
no, that's
anything.
Right.
I
that's
asked
right.
Him,
I noticed
told
that.
Him what my intentions were. He acknowledged it and said he understood. And they all just walked away denying my civil right to follow a complaint.
So what action are you taking?
Huh?
Are you taking some
yeah,
action
file
that
a
now?
Yeah, I'm going down
complaint.
There to file a complaint now against him.
I'm going to sign off soon, but...
And since
Let's sign off on a site of the banyans here. That banyan grows at the site. There was once a flagpole that on July 31st, 1843, the Hawaiian flag was re-raised when sovereignty was returned to the Hawaiian nation, to the Hawaiian people, on July 31st, 1843, from a short British gunship takeover, and was returned on behalf of the Queen by Admiral Thomas. I think it was Richard Dalton Thomas. Okay, signing off. Thanks for joining us. And I will return as the situation comes.